bracket. So we're going to break down some teams and get John's thoughts and everybody's thoughts on some Major League Baseball teams besides the Yankees that have improved this offseason. We have a two-headed monster as it regards the Chicago White Sox. Meredith, we'll start with you.
They had a sneaky good offseason, but let's be honest, they had a lot of improving to do. They were 72-89 last season. And take a look at some of the additions. Gio Gonzalez, Dallas Keuchel, Edwin Encarnacion, Mazzara. I'm missing one, Jack. Who am I missing?
Edwin Encarnacion.
There we go. So we got a little bit more offense. And it's not just about the names that they acquired. They also have a lot of youth on that team. That's exciting. Michael Kopech's going to be another year older. Not to mention they have Jimenez in the outfield. That's certainly a team to watch in the Central.
That's why Meredith and I ended up picking the same team. Because if you were looking for a pick to click, a team that is going to absolutely win more games than it did last season, pick the Chicago White Sox. Not just for the players they added, but I'm in agreement with Meredith. Moncada is a rising star. Anderson won a batting title last year. She mentioned Jimenez. They signed a young Cuban outfielder, Robert, to a six-year, $50 million deal before he's ever played a game in the major leagues and basically said, go be our center fielder for the next 6 years. And on top of that, I think they're in a softer division.
Yeah.
I think the Twins are going to fall back. I think the Indians are a little bit stuck. I don't know if they want to contend or want to rebuild. I think this could be a big year for the White Sox.
All right, so John, you looked at the landscape in baseball. Who do you think has improved greatly?
Well, I think the Angels have. I don't know if they have the pitching. I mean, you have to see it to realize it. But they're going to have a lot of power. They added Anthony Rendon, who's about as good as any hitter. Ohtani will be back full-time. Mike Trout, Albert Pujols. So they're going to have a tremendous power on their team. It's been years since the Angels were a big team, but it could be this year.
You know, I also wonder that Joe Maddon factor, right? It seems when he changes teams, there's always a little bit of a ripple effect.
Oh, he's a terrific manager. He'll get the most out of them. But, you know, he doesn't pitch. That's always, it's always right. Comes down to the pitching. But they're going to score a lot of runs.
All right, we'll see what they do with pitching. They have signed a couple kind of second-tier guys. We'll see where that goes. All right, did you stick American League or did you go National League?
No, I went National League. National League East, I think the Philadelphia Phillies made some really good moves. I think bringing in D.D. Gregorius, obviously, and Jack, you talked about this, a guy who's probably going to rebound this year. Zach Wheeler added to that rotation. You have Andrew McCutchen, who's going to come back healthy this year. That's going to be big for them. But the name at the bottom there, Joe Girardi, the new manager. I'm curious to see what Joe Girardi does with this team. It was a talented team to begin with, a very tough division. But did Joe Girardi take the year or two off and basically regroup a little bit, become a little bit more player-friendly? I think Gabe Kapler, those teams, they faded down the stretch. I don't think Joe Girardi's clubs are going to do that. He's a master with the bullpen, keeping guys healthy. David Robertson probably comes back at the end of the year. I think Joe Girardi's going to make a big difference for that ball club.